So I'm still in my search here for the subject heading that I selected. So I'm going to go back to my original title search. And it gives me my original results of 88 books. I'm going to go ahead and go back into that first title because I do want to show you these tools and features that are available in the catalog. So you can print the information about this book. If you click the print button, you'll kind of see here in the background, but also in my print preview, it's giving me all of these details about the book, subject headings, contents, description, the title, the author, the call number is included here at the bottom. I can print this if I want to keep this information. I can also save it as a PDF. So if you're interested in that feature, that's there for you. You can also email that information to yourself. So the same information that you see in the print feature, you will get that emailed to yourself. The permalink is a permanent link to this book title, and that's this link up here at the top as well. So if you click on this and copy this to your clipboard and you paste it into an email, let's say you can email yourself this title or email it to somebody else. And when they click on that link, it will directly open to this page and they will get all the information about this book. Another really cool feature about this catalog is the citation button, which we did not have in our old catalog. So you click on citation and it will generate a citation for this book. This is the MLA 8th edition, but there are other editions, or sorry, other citation styles here for you to choose from. But you really want to make sure that you're double checking your citations. It is noted here in the catalog as well. These are not 100% accurate. They do make mistakes. So for example, this backslash right here should not be included. So you always want to double check based on the style guides for the style that you're using. Don't just copy paste. Always double check. And even if you do copy paste from here and add it to your works cited page, you're still going to need to do a little bit of formatting as far as putting them in alphabetical order, making sure you have that hanging indent, and making sure you have the correct font and font size, etc. But it is a really cool feature. It does do about 90% of the work for you. You just have to do the double checking. Okay, from here, we're going to go ahead and exit out from the title details, and that's with this X button right here on the left-hand side. So I'm going to click on that, and that takes me back to my page of results. So I want to point out to you the filters on the left-hand side, and this is something we're going to see in our databases as well in another video. These filters are to help reduce your results to what you're really looking for, kind of getting rid of the stuff that you don't need. Now, remember I mentioned that right now our catalog is only looking through books in the library, so you're not going to get any journal article results or anything like that right now. So here in availability, there are two options held by library. So that means it is a physical print book that you can check out and borrow for 3 weeks. Or available online, which means it's an ebook that you can access through our catalog or through our databases. So you can select one of these if you don't want to look at ebooks, or if you only want to look at ebooks, this is where you would make your selection. And then you have by location. Let me click on show more. So circulation desk and reserve books. These are going to be books that you cannot take home. There are books that you can only borrow here in the library for 2 hours. So if you want to make sure that it's a book you can take home, that would be a circulating book. Then you can select this and get rid of everything else. So I clicked on this and immediately at the bottom, I got a button that says to clear or to apply filters. If I click clear, it's going to delete this check if I click Apply Filters, it's going to do what I asked it to, which is give me only the list of titles that are circulating books. But I'm going to keep scrolling down and look at my other filters to see if there's anything else I want to add to this search. Now, resource type, if I click Show More, it's really only going to show me books right now because, as I've mentioned already, that is how we currently have the catalog set up, to only show us books. So I don't really need to do much there. There's one oddball journal, but that shouldn't be there anyway. And then we have subjects. So very similar to what I already showed you, where for each title you have a list of subject titles that you can click on and do a search for those. Here, very similarly, you're going to see some subject terms that you can select to kind of narrow down your search. So if you want to focus on the United States or North American, Mexican American border region, you can do that. Border security. And then you have some odd subjects here, politics and government. Now you'll notice there is a number listed next to each one of these subject terms. So United States is 28, immigration is 15. This is how many titles there are that have a subject related to this. And you'll notice here at the bottom, it stops at 4 for Hispanic Americans. There actually are more subject terms that will give you like 3 books or 2 books or 1 book. But unfortunately, the way that this new catalog is set up, it only shows you a limited amount of subject terms. There's unfortunately nothing we can do about that. It's just the way the interface is. But just keep that in mind. You're not seeing the whole picture, unfortunately, but what you can see here, you can select from. I'm going to go ahead and collapse that. I'm not going to make any selections. And then you have publication date. Okay, this might be the most important depending on your topic. It's currently looking from 1913 to 2019. Rio Hondo Library has been around for over 60 years, so we do have a lot of older books. Okay, now with the border wall, obviously you're gonna want books that are a little more current, more recent, because you want to know what's happening now. So you can always change this date, and there is a little up down arrow where you can do that, or you can just go in, delete, and type in your search. So for example, maybe you want to know what's been going on since Trump came into office. You can type in the year of his inauguration, or maybe a year or two before that. I'm going to go ahead and do 2015. And I'm also going to change this because it says 2019, but we're in 2020 now. And we should have some books possibly from 2020. So I'm doing the last 5 years, basically, and I'm going to check off that box to make that refined year of publication. And then if I wanted, I could do author, and then I can also select language. Okay, so you'll notice there's one in Spanish, one in Chinese, Irish, that's interesting. And then 88 in English. So if you want to make sure they're in English, you can make that selection there. And then I'm going to click Apply Filters, and it will now update to give me what I want. Okay. Now you'll notice here on the top left, it says Active Filters. These are the filters that I selected. Okay. If I want to remove one of these, I can just click the X, and it tells you there that it will remove the filter. If I want to get rid of all of them, I can click Reset Filters, and it will take me back to my original search. With these filters in place, I have 18 results. And scrolling through, you can see the publication date because I specifically asked for 2015 to 2020. Apparently, we don't have anything 2020, so it defaulted back to 2019. So for the last 4-year window, these are the books that we have related to my word search that I typed in at the top. Okay. Now, the next thing I'm going to show you is how to access our eBooks.